Again, we have here triangle QPR, wherein all sides are given. Unfortunately, there is no such angles given. So we need to look for the angles itself. We have here the side QP is 13, the side PR is 11, and the side QR is 18. What is the unit of measure? I'm so sorry.
CM.
I must write CM. So what angle do you want me to look? Any angle will do. Come on. Angle P. Do you want me to look for the angle P? Angle P. Okay lang? Oh, sige. Let's look for the angle P. We are looking for the cosine rule. So we're going to look for the cosine of P. So cosine of P must be equals to what? 13 squared plus 11 squared minus 18 squared over 2 of 13 and 11. So answer. Answer, come on. 13 squared plus 11 squared minus 18 squared over 2 times 13 times 11. And that will give us what? It's okay, come on.
Negative
0. Give me 4 decimal places. Is it exactly? 0.1188. Next, what are we going to do next? Divide both sides by cos. And what do we do if we have the cosine as the denominator? 4 decimal. Why? Okay, ang katabi rin ng 8 ay 8. So this 8 becomes? Be careful in rounding off numbers. Next, what are we going to do with this cos? Magiging cos negative 1. So P is the cos of negative 1 multiplied by the negative 0.1189. And that answer will be, P is now?
83.17.
So, 83.7 for the angle P. Parang nag-ano yung ano ko ha. Parang party-party lang ha. Next. So, angle P is 83.17. How do we get the other sides? Or the angles?
Other angles.
Side rule.
Okay, now we can now use the side rule. Can I just erase?
Yes.
Okay lang yan. Ang mahalagang meron. Okay, next. How do we apply side rule? The sign of the given angle. Sign of 83. Over what? 18. And it must be equals to what?
Sine.
Any angle you want. Is it Q or R? Okay, sige. Let's look for the sine Q. Over what?
11.
What do we do next? We do the cross multiplication. We have here the sine 83.17 times 11. And it must be sine Q of 18. Ang gagaling. Then, sine Q is now 4 decimal places. Come on. 4 decimal places. 0.6068. Why 4 decimal places for us to get the more exact answer? I'm not saying this is an exact answer. But more on ano, mas malapit siya na nasagot. Is it clear?
Yes.
Next, what are we going to do with this one?
By sine.
So this one, again, we are not allowed to do this. So we are going to make this one sine
negative.
So we have here the sine negative 1.
Q is equals to sine negative 1 of 0.6068.
Hindi na siya nakikita.
And Q is?
37.36.
Therefore, angle Q is 37.36. Are we done?
No.
What are we going to do?
Sine R.
Okay, how?
Add
what?
The
two given angles, we have here 83.17 plus 37.36. And that will give us what? Come on, help me.
120.53.
Is it correct? Are we done?
No.
What are we going to do with 120? By the way, why do we subtract it from 180? The sum of the angles of a triangle is always? And your answer here will be? 69.47. 59? 9. Okay, we have here 59.47. So angle R is 59.47. And then we're done.